The date was November 1st, 2018, around 1 month before Ultimate's official release. We just finished watching over a half hour of exciting news, including announcements for Ken and Incineroar, and Sakurai was wrapping up his tantalizing preview of the Fighter's Pass. He suddenly revealed a sneak peek of a limited time offer, and the screen faded to black. Certainly no one knew what to expect as dazed Mario characters filled the screen to retro World 8 music, and before we knew it, piranha plant? No, there's no way they put a piranha plant in Smash. Well, they did. Piranha Plant was confirmed as a special DLC character that would be free for those who registered Smash Ultimate within the first few months. Its quirky moveset was shown off using various abilities from fellow plants across the Super Mario game series. The hilariously unexpected nature of Plant also immediately led to hundreds of memes and the Plant Gang hashtag. Sadly, the character itself is somewhat of a meme. Initial impressions of Piranha Plant were quite poor, with most players throwing it right into low tier. As time went on, however, talented players such as Brood began to show that the character's unique special moves offered some potential. Between Plant's neutral and side special, it's very difficult to approach this character, and as a fairly campy zoner, you'll often have to. Brood showed that these moves could create many traps, and the character's weight and combo-breaking ability made it difficult for opponents to KO. All of this didn't amount to much, however, and Plant is still regarded as a lower mid-tier character at best. So, for our question of the day, how would you buff Piranha Plant? Stay tuned as we break down this character's weaknesses and share your own insights on how we could fix them. Hey guys, Bonk here, and if you'd like to learn more about Piranha Plant or any character, check out the resources on ProGuides.com. We've got live classes, pro courses, and instant access to coaching so you can get exactly what you need to improve. You can also check out the ProGuides community on Discord and Reddit. Now, on with the video. What makes Plant so bad anyway? Its special moves have lots of strong utility, but its normals, not so much. Piranha Plant is essentially a bunch of slow frame data in a pot. It lacks reliable spacing tools in neutral, with fair, nair, and back air coming out pretty slowly with lots of landing lag. These moves don't have much range either, they don't really start combos, and only back air, the slowest of the three, is good at killing. Plant's aerials are just flat out bad, and aerials are generally the most important tools in a character's moveset due to their versatility and safety, so this really holds it back. Plant is also pretty slow on the ground and really slow in the air, so this character is awful at approaching and winds up relying on many tricks and gimmicks in neutral and disadvantage. Speaking of disadvantage, Neutral B and Down B are its few saving graces. Plant's neutral special, Patooey, is a strong, Gordo-like projectile that will drop down and counter-hit if the player mashes B when getting hit. This won't break true combos, but makes it very difficult to juggle the plant without taking a spike ball to the face. Long Stem Strike, Plant's Down B, has armor while it charges, adding another trick to mess up eager attackers. But at the end of the day, that's just what these are. Tricks. Plant has terrible aerials to rely on in disadvantage and poor drift speed, so its only hope is for you to overcommit. Plant has terrible aerials to rely on in disadvantage and poor drift speed, so its only hope is for you to overcommit and succumb to its gimmicks. As you'd expect, this only goes so far at high levels of play, and Plant winds up struggling in disadvantage nevertheless. This is even more apparent offstage, where Plant's up B offers little protection besides some small hitboxes on the sides. The Piranhacopter travels pretty far, but strong edgeguarding characters like Lucina and Game & Watch will run off without hesitation and turn Plant into the newest vegan burger trend. Plant's normals aren't just slow and generally weak, but they also offer very little combo potential. It has some cool setups using falling up air and neutral B, but finding a falling up air isn't very practical, and nothing else will start nearly as strong of a combo. Alright, let's take a look at your ideas on how to fix the plant to be a viable character. First up, viewer Michelle McKenzie says, make Nair actually combo, speed up fair, less startup and safer on shield, improve F tilt in everything, make down tilt combo, make dash attack kill at high percents, maybe 170, speed up down B tilting motion, give it some throw combos, and reduce lag on side B. A lot of great points here. Nair is basically useless. It's similar to Ivysaur's Nair, for example, which is great out of shield and can start and end combos. Plant's Nair, on the other hand, or Leaf, does none of this for the most part. You can't get guaranteed dragdown setups because it has too much landing lag, its knockback angle makes follow-ups impossible, and Plant has nothing to consistently link into it with. A good multi-hit Nair can make a huge difference. Just look at Byleth. Plant's fair being faster would be great for spacing in neutral, and reducing its landing lag would also make it safer on shield and create potential follow-up opportunities. A change to the animation of this move might help too, because it swings from below, making it tricky to space fair very low to the ground. Down tilt combos would be great too, although it isn't very easy for Plant to find a down tilt either way, considering the way it keeps opponents out. This is why throw combos would be a bigger help. In that mid-range, Plant is very good at conditioning players into shield, especially with Poison Breath. In these moments, a quick dash grab callout is an effective strategy, and getting some real follow-ups would be a big buff. This could be done by adjusting the knockback angle such that up air can be connected, and perhaps reducing lag on the throw as well. Pretty much every other Mario character has throw combos anyway. Dash attack killing would be a small quality of life change, but decent, and the faster angle on down B would make it less reactable and disadvantage. Since Plant has to start this move facing straight up, it's really easy to react to before the pot tilts low enough to hit you. Reducing lag on side B would be pretty big, potentially. The Cloud of Poison Breath is one of Plant's most dangerous tools. Its immense damage keeps players out in neutral and makes Plant very solid at ledge trapping. With less lag, Plant could access more traps using this move and cover the ledge even better. It's the kind of change that would literally make the character more toxic, but if we're keeping it within its archetype, this could be a big help. Next, Daniel Dorito says, increased ground speed, increased aerial mobility, bigger hitbox and less end lag on Bear, less startup on Patooie, less startup and end lag on Dare, faster and further up B, and make down B grab ledge. That last one might be the most interesting Plant change so far. Down B would be a great recovery option if it could grab ledge, because it has a strong hitbox. It would still be vulnerable to edgeguards, but offer a useful mix-up to the lackluster up B. Increased movement speed would be very helpful. Depending on how much we'd improve this, we could even see some nerfs to Plant specials justified. A faster Plant wouldn't rely as much on gimmicks and traps, which would likely lead more players to pick up the character. All of that being said, movement speed won't do much if the character's normals aren't buffed. As Daniel suggested, reduced end lag on Bear would be one of many useful changes. This move is laggy enough to land with, but in the air, it's over a full second before you can act out of this move. Big yikes for edgeguarding with it. Speaking of edgeguarding, downer buffs would help too. Plant's Dare is actually pretty quick already. It's faster than Palutena's, if you believe that. The issues mainly come from this move's unreliable hitboxes, with the first hit only lasting 2 frames and only one part of the move spiking. Patooie doesn't really need less startup because of the combo-breaking nature of the ball, but an up B speed buff would be nice. Even with its tiny hitboxes, a faster Piranhacopter would make it harder to edgeguard the Plant. Viewer Roy Kuchiki brings up a suggestion we're seeing a lot. Remove extended hurtboxes on down B. When Plant shoots out its head, flower, well, whatever that is, when Plant shoots it out, it's still part of the Piranha Plant's body, so you can hit it, even though it's usually very far away from the pot. This results in wild situations where you can spike Plant from a great distance because it will still get launched from the location of the pot. Realistically, Plant doesn't get hit out of down B too often, but it certainly seems like something that shouldn't happen. To fix this, removing a hurtbox wouldn't really make sense because the Plant's body is technically still there, so they could simply make the head intangible. That's basically the same thing as removing the hurtbox, but it makes more sense. Lastly, Aaron Heininger says, first thing I'd do is make it so he can still attack after using his up special. Another interesting idea. Many characters like Olimar, Mega Man, and Sonic don't go into free fall out of their up specials, and in some cases, they can even cancel the up special with certain actions. If Plant could use a directional air dodge out of up B, it would gain another recovery mix-up and allow for more possible recoveries. Also, being able to attack out of Piranhacopter would give it the option to recover high and land on stage with aerials and other moves to defend itself. Overall, what Plant needs most is a better functioning normal kit and some small speed buffs. Its special moves are already very solid, and with some better frame data and combo potential on its normals, Plant would be able to play in more situations without being forced into its predictable zoning routine. What character would you fix in Smash Ultimate? Let us know in the comments and subscribe to ProGuides to see if your choice makes the cut.